Good morning, everyone, and happy Monday. My name is Julie, and I am here with your TipRanks pre-market morning update, where we are covering everything you need to know before the opening bell. I am here Monday through Friday with videos out before the market opens. So make sure that you subscribe to the channel and turn on those notifications so you stay up to date with all of our latest videos. Today, we are discussing some notable stock market news, our biggest gainers and losers, plus earnings reports. So here we go. In stock market news, US futures are lower this morning as the hefty valuations in the tech sector continue to weigh down the market. As of filming, Dow futures were down about 0.08%, S&P 500 futures down about 0.6%, and NASDAQ futures down 1.4%. In stimulus package news, the US Senate passed President Biden's $1.9 trillion stimulus package on Saturday. It is expected to easily pass a vote in the House when it is taken up on Tuesday. Pharmaceutical company Eli Lilly received praise from the European Medicines Agency Committee for Medicinal Products for Human Use for its antibody treatment for confirmed COVID cases. Eli Lilly CEO David Ricks said that today's CHMP recommendation is another important milestone in our efforts to extend access to antibody therapies for patients with COVID around the world, providing a pathway for more EU countries to enable use of potentially life-saving treatments. The Eli Lilly stock comes in as a strong buy and was up over 3% as of close on Friday and is trading down about 0.4% in the pre-market so far. Energy and oil company Chevron has agreed to purchase limited partnership Noble Midstream in an all-stock deal to simplify governance and corporate structure. Per the terms of the deal, Chevron, which has majority holdings in Noble Midstream, will acquire all 33.925 million of the publicly held common units. Chevron, who is also rated a strong buy, was up over 4% as of close on Friday and is now up another 0.69% in the pre-market today. In reopening news, we have SeaWorld, who just announced that their amusement parks in Orlando, San Antonio, and San Diego are now reopened and will be operating with extended hours. However, in the San Diego theme park, the rides, roller coasters, and indoor animal exhibits will continue to remain closed. Last month, the company reported better-than-expected fourth-quarter results, with revenues of $154 million, topping street estimates of $122 million. SeaWorld is rated with a strong buy and was up over 4% as of close on Friday, but is down about 0.8% in the pre-market. And lastly, we have the cybersecurity technology company CrowdStrike, who has completed the cash-in-stock acquisition of Humio, a provider of high-performance cloud log management and observability technology. CrowdStrike CEO George Kurtz said that Humio will enhance CrowdStrike's ability to solve real-world customer problems with its cloud-native platform by adding index-free data ingestion and analyst capabilities for both first- and third-party data. CrowdStrike is rated a strong buy, with 15 buy ratings and 3 holds, but they did close down about 5% on Friday and are down 1.2% in the pre-market. Now, moving over to this morning's biggest gainers and losers. Starting off with Anciano Therapeutics. Under the ticker ANCN, Anciano Therapeutics is currently up about 68.5% in the pre-market. This seems to be from investors reacting to a letter sent out to shareholders about a potential merger. Other big movers include Second Sight Medical Products. Under the ticker EYES, or EYES, they are currently up 45% in the pre-market after jumping 304% on Friday, as well as OpGen. Under the ticker OPGN, they're currently up about 31% in the pre-market after closing up nearly 9% on Friday. Some of our biggest losers this morning include Comstock Home Building Companies, who is currently down just over 9%, SciFi Technologies, who's down nearly 15%, and Luokung Technology, who is down 16.23% so far in the pre-market. Now, taking a look at some notable earnings reports. Just this morning, we heard from Chinese EV maker XPeng. They reported a narrowing loss in the fourth quarter and deliveries that beat their own expectations by 30%. Wall Street expected a loss of 12 cents per share on revenue of $411.38 million. XPeng lost 15 cents a share, but revenue surged to $437 million. XPeng, under the ticker XPEV, is currently up nearly 3% in the pre-market. At the end of last week, we saw results from Broadcom, who delivered better than expected first quarter results and marked significant year-over-year improvements in sales and profitability. Their first quarter adjusted earnings of $6.61 per share beat consensus estimates of $6.57 and grew nearly 26% year-over-year. Their revenues rose about 14% year-over-year to $6.66 billion and top Street's estimates of $6.62 billion. Broadcom, under the ticker AVGO, comes in as a strong buy, and after these results, we saw a lot of analysts update their price targets for an average potential upside of about 15%. We also heard from Ruth's Hospitality, who closed over 6% higher on Friday after they reported fourth quarter earnings that topped Street's estimates. They reported earnings of 3 cents per share compared to the Street's expectations of break-even earnings. Meanwhile, the company's revenues of $77.4 million declined over 42% year-over-year and fell short of consensus estimates of $77.8 million. And we also heard from Big Lots, whose shares closed up over 2% on Friday as their fourth quarter adjusted earnings came in at $2.59 per share, beating the Street estimates of $2.50. Their company's gross margin was $685.2 million in the quarter. In the after hours today, we're expecting earnings reports from Stitch Fix, Del Taco Restaurants, and Casey's. So that is our Monday pre-market morning update. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and if you did, make sure you hit that thumbs up button and leave your thoughts in the comments down below. We will see you back here tomorrow morning. I hope you have a great day. Thanks.